Do you guys remember that episode of SpongeBob when SpongeBob committed mass genocide on an entire town? Do ya? Season 11, episode 47, Bubble Town. The episode where SpongeBob accidentally commits mass genocide. You can't make this stuff up, folks. You just can't. Our friend SpongeBob is a kind, loving, go-getter optimist who always wants to do what's best for his friends. Think of all the amazing things that he's done. He helped SpongeBob. He helped Squidward with the Bubble Bowl. He helped Mr. Krabs with Mrs. Puff. He's helped so many people. So why did he commit mass genocide? Let's see in this episode of Reading Too Deep into Cartoons, Volume 7. Now this episode might seem like any other silly bubble episode, because SpongeBob, boy, he flippin' loves bubbles. He loves it. And he's hanging out with his best little Pally McGee bubble buddy, and he went to his home. And now that's pretty kind of SpongeBob, and now he's helping all these people. So you're like, oh my gosh, it's just like a nice little episode, right? No. No, it is not. In this episode, SpongeBob commits some of the most heinous atrocities I've ever seen in a cartoon.
But you seem to have stepped in my dogs.
Pardon me, ma'am. Let me just...
PETA's gonna have a field day with this one.
Go watch my second channel, Flaundromat Reviews. I review movies. I made a video about Pirates, Band of Misfits, and the show Community. Go watch it. Go watch it now. If you're a fan of me, you'll like this, and you also like movies, then I was gonna have Flaundromat Reviews. Oh no, SpongeBob, you stepped in her dogs. What are you gonna... Oh no, you just stepped on her face. Oh my gosh, what are you doing, SpongeBob? SpongeBob, what are you doing? SpongeBob, no! Oh, phew. For a second, I thought SpongeBob... Oh my gosh! No, not the duckies. Not the duckies, SpongeBob. Anyone but the duckies. Oh no, SpongeBob, why would you do that? No, the towns, you're destroying them. Imagine all the people there. Oh no, they're not gonna. They wouldn't. They would never. But they would never. They would never. The Jake murdered a child. They got SpongeBob freaking SquarePants to murder an innocent child on screen. What? But Flaundromat, I mean, semen, flip. Should I keep that in? No, I probably shouldn't keep that in.
But see, Minion, those aren't actual people. They're just bubbles. You're a flipping idiot. Oh my gosh, I'm a frog.
Well, viewer fanbase, if you let me finish for 5 flipping seconds. Yeah, they are flipping bubbles.
Always available, because these high-tech buses can account for any number of passengers. Here are...
But they're also sentient. That baby he just crushed? Sentient. All of those children? Sentient. That school? Probably had people in it. Bubble Buddy is sentient.
SpongeBob! Oh, thank goodness you're okay!
Oh yeah, good thing he's okay. Too bad little freaking Charlie Bubble Man isn't.
But see, Minion, you need to have a more darker sense of humor, you sensitive little snowflake. Shut up!
I have a dark sense of humor. Have you seen my mattress video? Frickin' put on the TVMA warning for that garbage. I love things like cyanide and happiness and Trover saves the something something. But I'm sorry, but SpongeBob is just not something that screams dark humor to me. That's like if you're watching Sesame Street and flippin' Rosita gets mugged. It is just so completely out of left field. Like, you got one episode of them singing songs about how fun friendship is, and then you got another episode where SpongeBob completely desolates an entire town of individuals. And you know what the worst part of it all is? First off, an old man died for a few seconds, so you know that's fun. And second, Mr. Krabs is all complaining, splaining about how, oh no, SpongeBob's not here, I can't make any of me money. And I'm like, SpongeBob's in flipping jail! And you're worried about your money? And I know Mr. Krabs caring about money, how out of left field! But flipping, oh my gosh, you sold them for 62 cents. So then SpongeBob gets flipping broken out of bubble prison by Mr. Krabs. And what did we learn? I don't flipping know. And then Mr. Krabs kills everyone. Guys, what's your favorite episode of SpongeBob? Mine is the one where two of the main characters murder people. What? Everyone is flipping talking about how shocking this is and write a bunch of news articles on that. But no one's flipping talking about the episode where SpongeBob and Mr. Krabs murder people in cold blood. SpongeBob at least feels bad about it. Mr. Krabs is just flipping like, oh my gosh, me bucko, who gives a flying poop nugget about all those people we just murdered? Let's just flipping get some more if it means I could get myself some Krabby Patties. Shut up, the Great American Baking Show. You don't make up for this travesty that has happened today. Oh, by the way, the baking thing is an ad on the SpongeBob episode I'm watching. I didn't just bring that up for no reason. That sounded kind of weird that I just brought it up. I mean, at least SpongeBob brings everything back. But, I mean, that's like murdering someone, taking their body parts, and then stitching it back together. Did this become too morbid? I don't know. Maybe. And the only flipping reason Mr. Krabs did it was so he could make another restaurant. He has no regard for human ethics. This is the face of a true monster. So, fanbase, what did you think of the episode? It was awful. Yep, well, you know, so is life. You got people like flippin' Karsten that guy with his flippin' Squarespace sponsorship talking about the SpongeBob's darkest episode. Buddy, I got it right here. It's called Bubble Town. Why don't you go talk about robots again? But at the end of the day, does anyone care? No. I don't care. You don't care. I'm sure Karsten Runquist, if I'm saying that wrong, I'm sorry. I'm sure he doesn't care. And I'm 100% certain Danny DeVito doesn't care. Well, that was a video.